Hey everyone, I'm live from an open house that just wrapped up and I have a couple of key things just for you to help you with your open houses when they start, as they're going, and when they finish. First and foremost, when you get into the open house, first off, get there on time. Prepare the outside, any signage you want to put out there, okay, get it out there quickly, okay? Be on time though, consumers will show up on time in many cases. Second, turn on all the lights, and I mean every single one of them, no matter if it's sunny or cloudy outside. It's important to make sure this is a showroom ready to go for your customers when they come in. Okay, another tip, open the shades, open the windows up, okay? If it's too cold outside, I suggest still opening the windows, letting out any of the stale air, so this way it's nice and fresh when people come in. And that leads me to another thing, bring some air freshener, light some candles. Do something to aerate the place, okay? No, you don't have to bake cookies, okay? Just get in there, use some common sense. Flush the toilets, look inside the refrigerator, make sure there's nothing funky inside there, because consumers will go through the cabinets and the refrigerators just to take a quick peek, okay? I've got an agent who is in our office, and he's gonna talk about preparing for the open houses as well and how he prepares for them. Okay, this is Kaylin. He's with my office. Say hello, Kaylin.
Hi.
So Kaylin, first, I see you're all dressed up over here. What do you believe some of the most important things preparing for an open house?
Oh, I believe that first of all, the people that come will see you before they even see the house, so you should be dressed for success. Number two, you might say that it has to be really, the smell inside has to be good. So I came about an hour before and I opened all the windows, all the shades up. I had all sorts of air freshener I put around. So it really smells quite better than it was before. And I mean, you feel also much better than before when you enter first the apartment. So the same way the client will feel the same as you feel, and it will actually improve the quality of service you provide.
So let's talk also now about open house sheets, sign-in sheets, whether you're using an app like Open House, an open house app, or just paper, okay? Guys, be an active agent. The key here is be active. I see so many agents over the years not be active. They just sit themselves down on a couch, check their phones, and do nothing else, okay? When a customer walks in, greet them, say hello, okay? You should be signing them in, unless it's really, really overwhelming inside the open house where they sign in, but you should be signing them to ask them the proper information, okay, when they come in. Your seller client expects that of you. Okay, what do you think about that, Kaylin?
I agree with you, absolutely agree.
Got it. Yeah, and then when you're asking the customer for their information, like their full name and telephone number, make sure you let them know you're going to give them an item of value, right? And promise not to spam them, and be sure not to spam them. I promise you, you're not going to get Mickey Mouse at AOL.com, and you'll get more phone numbers when you're active. When you leave the open house sheet just on a countertop and say, hey, just sign in, most likely they're going to give you 718-123-456-789-1011, whatever number, and they're going to give you Mickey Mouse at AOL.com. So give them something of value, right? Whether it's the open house sheet or whether some refreshments. And I promise you, it's the law of reciprocity. They will give you your information. Okay, nothing that obviously for privacy reasons, nothing personal, just more their first name, last name, and their telephone number. And the source in which they found you, right? Whether it's a website, whether it's a magazine, something, find the source. This way you know where to concentrate your efforts when marketing. Is that right, Kaylin?
Absolutely. And one tip I would like to say is always check the phone numbers, because some people are, if it's handwritten, it's difficult to read, and then important contact may be lost. I had actually open house a few weeks ago, and I had to try about 15 different combinations until I find out the right person.
So. And boy, I'm sure that's happened to you. It's happened to all of us over the years. So I want to keep this video just to tighten up the time over here. I want to let you know another thing about open house data. Guys, today, portals have put a price tag on consumer data. So when you leave, make sure if you're using an app, okay, and or a piece of paper, it doesn't get lost, right? So that piece of paper, you know, the one that you stick between the car seat, yeah, make sure it's nice and organized, clear. As Kaylin just mentioned, the phone numbers are clear. Okay, that is your responsibility, to especially if you're representing the seller. Okay, that's all the time I have for today. I hope you rock the open houses today. Speak to you soon. Bye now.
Bye-bye.